Good morning and thank you for tuning in to the Live and Five show where we are living live. I'm Jimmy Singh.
And I'm Alexis Nuquez. We've got the list of the on-time home run winners.
And twins born in different years. How is that possible? We have that story coming up.
And how did Mid-Tennessee do in the bowl yesterday?
All of this and much more.
Coming up right after this.
What are you doing? You're adopted. Your parents never loved you.
Hey, what happened?
There's a bully.
Well, you should put a note in Rocco's box. He can help you out.
Okay, I'm gonna write a note right now.
That's what I'm here for.
Are you having any bullying problems on campus, or do you want to report something that you cannot tell a teacher or anyone else? You can write a note and drop it in this box here. It's anonymous, and no one will need to know that you dropped this note in the box. I retrieve the notes, and we'll find out what the problem is, and we will handle it for you. This box is located in the front office, and at any time you can walk by and drop your note in here.
Welcome back and now to the news.
We've got the on-time homeroom winners, starting with first place is Miss Berg and Miss Noriega's homeroom. And second place is Mr. Okamura's homeroom. Great job being on time, guys.
Social committee will be having a meeting today at lunch in the East Center to plan this year's half-year dinner celebration. Please join in if you have any ideas or you just want to eat lunch there.
Hey, 7th graders, are you interested in working in the cafeteria? Please go to see Mrs. Jackie to volunteer for your time to help at lunch.
Every Friday after school, including today, Tatsloff is selling Italian ice in front of the school. It's only $3. That's a yummy treat for you and your wallet.
Are you going to go get it?
Maybe.
Sounds good.
I don't have
Italian
any money,
ice?
Sounds
only
fancy.
Tasted Chinese ice. I don't know. Ever heard of twin being born in different years? Well, that's what happened to Brandon Lewis and Ashley Fansler, who had a very unique birth. On New Year's Eve, the couple welcomed their lovely baby girl, Madison Kareen Lewis, at 11:59 p.m. Moments later, Aiden Everett Lewis was born at 12 a.m. Wow. Not only were the twins born on different days, but different years. And just as the father of the twins said, it was definitely the best New Year's they had.
That's really, really cool.
I know. Has that ever happened, or is that
supposed to happen? I don't know. It's cool. Taking a look at Tetzloff's calendar, today is a minimum day, College Friday, and a social committee at lunch in the E-Center. And next week on Tuesday is a PTSA meeting, Wednesday is a spirit day, and Friday is a minimum day and college day. That's all for now. Let's wrap up the ongoing events. Now let's go to Victoria Lee with the weather. Good morning, Victoria.
Good morning, Alexis. It's gonna be yesterday. And next week it's all gonna be the same as this week, except there's no rain at all. So yeah, that's it. Let's take a look at the map. The United States is divided into snow and rain, and the other half is divided into cloud and sun. While west where we are is gonna be sunny or cloudy, and up past the Grace Lake or a little bit to the west, it's going to be raining or snowing. And underneath it, it's going to be like windy. So yeah, let's take a look at the 5-day forecast. It's going to be cloudy today, and tomorrow it's going to be cloudy also. While Sunday, it's going to be sunny, and Monday, Tuesday are going to be kind of cloudy. So, let's begin with Tristan with the wet poll.
Thank you, Victoria. For today's wet poll, I'm interviewing Kirsten. Now let's see what her comments are. So, hi, Kirsten.
Hey.
How are you?
Good.
That's good. Well, could you rate a wet poll?
What is your New Year's resolution?
Sit back, relax, and enjoy this video.
Hey, what's up, Trojans? I'm Melissa Gray, reporting for the Live and Five show, here to welcome you back from 2010. It's a new year, so let's see how you started 2011 off.
What is your New Year's resolution? I have none because I'm a loser.
To do good in school.
To get better grades.
To get into a higher level at my dance studio.
To hang around more with my friends.
To be a better person and to try not to fight with my sister.
No, I don't do resolutions. I set goals as they're needed throughout the year.
Is there anything you're looking forward to?
Meeting Justin Bieber.
Are you glad 2010 is over?
I am. It was a great year. Thoroughly enjoyed it. But I'm definitely looking forward to a 2011, and I'm hoping we have a much hotter summer this year.
Yes.
Why?
Because it's a fresh start and stuff.
Are you at least excited to begin a new year?
Yeah.
How come?
Because this one's too old.
Yeah?
How come?
It's a new year and I hope I don't die.
Yes, I am. 2011 will bring some new things. For one thing 2011 will bring, it'll be my last year as a bachelor as I get married in May. So that's going to be the most exciting thing going on this year.
2011 is here, so let's hope this year is filled with excitement and success. Have a good year and stay in school. I'm Melissa Gray reporting for the Live in 5 show.
These people have interesting New Year's resolutions. Well, here are the results for this past week's web poll. 14% of you guys want to eat better, 22% of you guys want to exercise more, 25% of you guys want to have a better attitude, 5% of you guys want to do better in school, 2% of you guys want to learn something new, 14% of you guys want to relax more, 3% of you guys want to spend time with the family, and 10% of you guys want to spend time with friends. Well, we want to hear all your comments, thoughts, and opinions. Be sure to visit us online at live5show.com to vote. Send your comments to WebPoll at live5show.com, and if they are good, we'll read it on the air. So Kirsten, would you prefer to leave school early or start later on minimum days?
Leave early.
Why?
Because if we leave early, we can enjoy the rest of our day.
Okay. Well, thanks, Kirsten. Well, that wraps up today's WebPoll. I'm Tristan Taylor. You guys have an awesome day, and I'll see you guys on Monday. Back to you, Jimmy.
Thank you, Tristan. You know, I prefer late school before, like, not leaving early because I hate mornings. Okay, well, it's now time to swing into action with your Live in 5 sports report with Aaron. Good morning, Aaron. How are you doing?
Good morning, Jimmy. Good. From the Northville to the Southville and everything between, this is your Live in 5 sports. I'm Aaron LaRue Brown. Miami of Ohio grabbed their first bowl game win since 2003 season. They won 35-21 against Mid Tennessee last night in the GoDaddy.com Bowl. Austin Bolter threw a total of 289 yards and scored 2 touchdowns in his 4th career start. Thomas Merriweather rushed a total of 100 yards and ran for 2 touchdowns. He had a great game. Playing in today's bowl, AT&T Cotton Bowl, is LSU versus Texas A&M. If you can't watch that, don't worry, because there will be many bowls this weekend. And here's something that's interesting. In hockey, two days ago, the Nashville Predators beat the Anaheim Ducks. But last night, the Predators also beat the LA Kings 5-2. The streaking Predators handed the Kings their 5th straight loss, and the Predators are now on their 4th straight victory. I'd like to give a shout out to Amanda Atiolano, whose birthday is on Sunday, and she goes to a lifeguard college. Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah. Okay, well, back to you, Jimmy.
Thank you, Erin. Well, tell her I said happy birthday from me. Oh, happy birthday. Okay, it's time to test your knowledge of today's Daily 411.
Which country introduced chocolate to the world? Spain, USA, France, or Mexico? Take 5. I think it's Mexico.
France. Bonjour. How do you say chocolate in French?
Oh, I got it right.
How do you say chocolate in French? No, it's
I don't
Mexico.
Know. I don't take French classes, but yeah.
Oh, yeah, because there are a lot of cocoa trees there. Really?
Okay, I can say one word.
You know what color chocolate is?
Brown, okay.
No, it's black, and I'm wearing black. Yes.
Okay.
Visit our website to watch today's broadcast online at 11.5show.com and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
That's the end of today's show. We'll see you back here on Monday. Something about the woman that wants you but don't need you. Hey, can't figure it out.
something about her.